disappointed, Gary, to lose the lead?
Yeah, I think it's 2 points drop for ourselves. Yeah, the goals that we conceded were poor from us, really, to be honest with you. Lack of concentration, and it's cost us dearly.
Not sure that Castle has, and maybe he's fighting for Alan a little bit as well on the
yeah.
side of that.
No, we knew that before the game. I talked about it before the game, that that would be the case, and I think they clearly showed that in their performance. And you know, but I just felt that we were dominant. But I think what happened is when we scored our goals, we scored our first, and then we conceded a poor goal just before half-time. What we talked about at half-time is that the game's there for us to win it if we go out there and do the right things and do what we've been doing, but with that little bit more quality. And I think we started the second half very well again, got the deserved goal. But I think at that point, once we got the second, I think possession for us became too easy. You know, we kept the ball too easily. And I think in those situations, which we have to learn very quickly, is that when it becomes too easy, that we don't get sloppy with it or we don't lose concentration. And I think that was our downfall with the second goal, and lack of concentration got countered, and then they scored the two chances that they had. They scored the goal, so that's the way it went.
Was there a little bit of a slight worry later on you might lose it?
Yeah, because the game had come quite open. I think the emphasis was on us. That I think, you know, you can quite clearly feel that, you know, the crowd and myself, the team, probably felt that how are we not winning this game? We better go and win the game, you know. And then that's where it becomes a little bit attack v attack, and they didn't have any chances or anything really, but I think either team could have won the game at the end or could have lost the game, but overall we should have won that game with a, you know, at least a couple goal margin.
Is it difficult because it's not something you can put right in the training ground?
No.
Something that you have to develop in games.
Yeah.
To keep concentration levels
better. Yeah, and I think, you know, I talked about it as well before, you know, when obviously you got the lead and we're at home, the emphasis is on us to go forward and, you know, be attacking, but they had settled for their shape and we were keeping the ball. We could have kept the ball at the back for 20, 30 minutes. So I said, you know, when the crowd get anxious like that and they want you to play, I said, just keep the ball. Just keep the ball, who cares? It's on the away team to try and come out at us and get the ball back off us. And I just think the possession had become so easy for us that that was our downfall, where our concentration. So it's definitely something that we'll talk about and a lesson hopefully learned.
Is it difficult to speak to players after? You don't want to probably be too hard on them.
No, I just give a fair assessment, balanced assessment, and the players, you know, they're intelligent players. They're not. I think they understand what went wrong and what doesn't. But it's just more disappointing that we should have really won the game. I think their keeper made some great saves, to be honest with you, some very good saves where we should have really, you know, extended our lead. But when you don't and you haven't quite put the game to bed, you always run the risk in this league of a team popping up with something out of nothing. And the two occasions Newcastle popped up with something, and they scored two goals. So it's the way it went. Well, I think my point was made blatantly clear once again today. It's absolute. I don't know what else I can say. I couldn't have said any more than what I said, and yet it seems to have gone unheard, because it was very clear for them to say. I think they had 10, 13, 14 fouls before anything even happened. So Jonjo gets booked, you know, before he booked anyone. Colaccini had, for instance, I said about Wickham last week, Colaccini had 4 or 5 knees in Boney's back. Nothing happens. But what can I do? I can't do any more than what I said this week.
And you've lost Georgia now for
yeah.
Well.
Yeah, but that's what we have to deal with. That's the way it is. 5 bookings, so obviously he won't be available for Stoke. Whoever will come in will hopefully do a good job.